Good evening and welcome to my home. I am excited. I'm going to answer some questions this evening that you guys have sent in, whether it be via Instagram, YouTube, in my DMs. I'm happy to be able to connect with you guys this way and answer some of your guys' questions. So let's get right into it. Join my live free class on how to build a game-changing triple threat. I teach this class often, so make sure you go down below in the link so that you can sign up for my next class at gamechangers.natashawatley.com/live class. I hope to see you there. You won't want to miss it. What did you learn about yourself playing abroad? Beyond being homesick, what was the hardest part? So one of the things that I think that I learned about myself playing abroad is that I'm really comfortable being by myself, which is actually a really good thing. I don't know if that I was surprised about it, but I think being over in Japan definitely confirmed it. So I'm an only child. I grew up, I didn't have siblings, so I always had to like entertain myself. Being in my own head, my own space, my own time, I definitely was very, very comfortable with that. Like, we practice a lot, and yes, you're with the team a lot, but there's also a lot of downtime where you are just literally by yourself. So I started to pick up cooking when I was in Japan. So I like loved going to the grocery store. They only sell things in like small packages. So whereas here you can go to the grocery store and like literally buy for a whole entire week, there you can buy for days at a time. So I loved going to the grocery store daily and buying fresh produce and getting fresh items and getting things to cook on that day. So I really started to pick up cooking. So that was one of the things that I learned about myself abroad, that is I like to cook. Like one of the things that I really appreciate about being abroad is that we are more alike than different. Japan is not a place that I like dreamt of going to being, but I learned that there's so many things like just in terms that we appreciate. Like we, Japanese culture, American culture, like we appreciate family, we appreciate food, we appreciate people. I really loved being there and just seeing how similar we are and how different we are. What's one lesson sports has taught you that has helped you in business? And I actually love this question. So kind of get to like tie all of my life together. And so I think the biggest thing that I've learned from sports that I have taken over into business is the first is just taking action. So I know a lot of times like we always have like these big goals that we want to reach and they seem so huge and it's like we don't even know how we're going to get there, but we just want this thing to happen and we dream about it and we think about it. But I think we got to take action. We got to take some type of action so that we can learn from it. So we almost sometimes get paralyzed because it's like, gosh, it seems so big. Like, how am I going to make it to college? How am I going to become an Olympian? But how am I going to do it? So I've got to make sure that I'm taking action. And I think that's the biggest thing that I've learned. It's like, okay, to be the best defender, I've got to take some ground balls. I've just got to get out there and I've just got to do it. I may not know what I'm doing. I may be stumbling over my feet at first, but after I take that first ground ball, I guarantee you will learn from that very first one to be better that second one. So it's all about just taking action and you just got to learn from it. I know it sounds so cliche, but in business, you just got to take a leap. Like, I don't know, I had to form an LLC, you know, you got to go and do it. But like, I don't even know who to talk to, but I just got to like pick up the phone and I got to call somebody, and someone may not, you called the wrong person, but that person's going to lead you to the next thing. It's like, honestly, you just got to take action so that you can get to that next step and so that you can get a little bit closer to that big goal. I have a 3-part mini video series on the slapping basics. Make sure you go down in the description below and get your video today. I love doing this. If you have more questions, I would love to do another video just like this. Make sure you leave them down in the comments below. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Make sure that you like this video, and I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for joining.